Second reading. I'm just gonna make this quick, but I feel like this is a word, this is what I'm really excited about sharing, and I'm fired up about it. It's about homeless in the Burnin Bush, so it is. But I wanna read something that jumped off to me. I love this story, obviously, the Lord called me into the ministry, and he told me I was gonna go out to Burnin Bush, my name is Stephen Bush, and so it's always been dear to my heart, this story, but I just wanna read something to you, and I know somebody's ready to receive this tonight. It's Exodus chapter 3. Basically, the story is you, as you know, and it's not, it's Moses, and he's out in the wilderness, and he's in the desert, and he sees this bush. And it says in chapter 3, it says this, it says, he led the flock to the back of the desert. And came to Horeb, the mountain of God, and the angel of the Lord appeared to him in a flame of fire from the midst of a bush. So he looked, and the bush was not consumed. The bush was burning with fire, catch this, it was not consumed. Then Moses said, I will now turn aside and see this great sight, why the bush does not burn. So when the Lord saw him, he turned aside to look back, calling him from the midst of the bush, and said, Moses, Moses. He said, here I am. And he said, not draw near this place, but take your sandals off your feet, for the place where you stand is holy ground. He said, I'm the God of your father, the God of Abraham, and God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. And Moses hid his face, for he was afraid to look upon God. And Father begins to talk about how he's seen the oppression of his people who are in Egypt. Now this is the part of what I want you to focus in on what you're doing. The Lord calls out the Moses from a bush to burn. And he says, I want you to turn your attention, Moses, not to the desert any longer. Then he said, I want you to turn your attention to the oppression of my people who are in Egypt. I have heard their cry with those of their taskmasters, and I know their sorrows. I have come down to deliver them out of the hand of the Egyptians, and to bring them up from that land to a good and large land, flowing with milk and honey. I want to stop right there. I want you to listen real quick. The creator of the universe that made Moses, that formed him, shaped him, formed him in his mother's womb. The Bible says you and I were made by the hands of the Creator. He formed and knit you together in your mother's womb. You're not an accident. He made you. He has an incredible plan for your life, just like Moses. He called Moses by name. He says, Moses, Moses. So basically, Father calls to Moses from a burning bush, and he says, get your eyes off the desert. You've been here for a minute. But turn your eyes and focus on my people because I heard their cry. Now, where were these people? They were in Egypt. They were under oppression. He said, I've heard their sorrows. I've heard their cries. Come to deliver them. So tonight, I want to speak to you guys, regardless of your age. This is for every person. This is for the citizens of you thing. It's not a teenager thing. It's not a young child thing. It's for everybody. You guys are the army of God. I believe that the Lord is sending tonight. I believe this with my whole heart. I believe he's sending this. I want you to focus your attention on the people I need you. And you're like, hold on, wait a minute. That's cool, man. You know, what's the truth is that you're not pretending, man. We don't live in Egypt. Yes, you do. Yes, you do. You live in Egypt. This world, unfortunately, has been corrupted since the Garden of Eden. It's been laid. It's been manipulated. It's been covered with sin, sorrow, shame, guilt. All these things the kingdom of darkness is pushing and power over people, pushing people down, holding people in bondage and captivity, brothers. But listen, it's just like it was when Moses went to Egypt. You got Egypt right here. And I believe that the creator of the universe is saying, I want you to go to Egypt. Matter of fact, I want you to leave this building we call church. And when you start your day tomorrow, know that you're in the middle of Egypt and there's people hurting. And there's people in captivity. And there's people in bondage. And there's sorrow. Listen, they got all these things they're carrying that they were never meant to carry. But you're walking around and you know the truth. You know that where the Spirit of the Lord is, there's freedom. You know that by the name and by the blood of Jesus Christ, you can be set free and delivered. There's no name above his name. This is stuff that you guys know. So you're just like Moses. You can leave the desert And you can walk right into Egypt and say to Pharaoh, let my people go. Some of you are in school with friends right now who are hurting. And all they need is somebody to have a little boldness. And let them God them to say, hey, listen, you don't have to hurt like that. You don't have to touch yourself. You don't have to go into your room and just put your pillow over your head and cry yourself to sleep at night. You don't have to live that way. Because you can come right into our region. And not only that, but you can leave the region with God's blessing. Amen? So tonight I want to challenge you each and every one of you. I know it's not a big word, I know it's not theology, but it's theologically deep, or however you want to say it, but it's a simple word that I serve God who works with simplicity and very intricate details. As you've heard our story tonight, he's at work everywhere around you. And he's saying to you tonight, if you're here, out of this bush, get out of the burning bush tonight. I'm not so bush in the middle of the desert, but my name is Stephen Bush. I don't speak on my authority or my behalf, I speak in his. And he says tonight, get out of here and go back to Egypt and tell my people that they can be free. Tell my people that they don't have to live like they're living. Can he come down and do it? Absolutely. Because he did when he took over the body of Jesus Christ. The Word became flesh. He died on the cross. He said it once and for all. But they don't get to be Jesus. You got it. He said, I'm going to fill you with the Spirit. You're going to be my friends. My feet. That fact, he was so far as to call it his ambassadors. Paul said he's going to be an ambassador for Jesus Christ. You know what an ambassador is? It represents the people. An ambassador shows up and they carry the weight of the people. They show up and they represent something much greater than they are. An ambassador. And you guys are ambassadors, man. You're called to go right into Egypt, right into Bethlehem, the town you came from, or surround the city. You're called to go right back into it and begin to tell people who they really are and who they can be in Jesus Christ. Do you believe that God? Thank you, Lord. Here's what I want you to do. We're going to talk about this. I want you to stand up. We're going to pray. We're going to have all men at the altar. We're going to listen to you again. And this is what I feel in my spirit. Amen. And this is so your desire. This is so what you want to be about. You long for it. You're like, man, I just want to be used. I know he's created me for something. I know I can be used. I don't know if I'm doing my part. Or some of you are saying, I am, but it's tough. I get weary. It's hard. But tonight you say it's only by his grace. Mm-hmm. It's only by his grace. Because we're going to fall. We're going to blunder. We're going to mess it up. Our image will let you down. But Jesus Christ is faithful.